Good morning. Grace and peace be to you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and happy Easter to you all. And welcome to Round Hill United Methodist Church for this Easter sunrise service. We are doing something kind of new to us and exciting for us. We are having a sunrise service that is both here in person and also live stream for those who are not able to make it out today. And so we're glad that you can be with us, those who are here on this beautiful day, hearing the birds as they are chirping and singing the glories of God. And we're glad that you can join us, too, those who are at home celebrating the goodness and the good news of Jesus Christ. It is a wonderful day that we are able to celebrate what Christ has done for us. And so as we prepare for this time of great celebration of Jesus' victory over death, let us prepare ourselves and our hearts and our minds in a time of prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks for your Son, Jesus Christ, and for the good news of this victory that we have through him. Help our hearts to be alive in the amazing love, the amazing good news that you have shown us in this day. As the sun rises this morning, help it to be a recognition of the Son who has risen and shown light into the darkness of the world. And all of this we pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus Christ brings light into the darkness. And so we light the Christ candle, recognizing Christ's light into the world. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. This morning we're going to begin with a hymn. It's one of the Methodist classics, Christ the Lord is Risen Today. I'll lead us in singing. You'll have the words up here to sing along with. If you're at home, you'll have them on your screen. And if you're here, if you have your mask on, you can feel free to stand, sit, sing however you'd like to as we celebrate the good news that Christ is risen today. So let us join in singing. Christ the Lord is risen today, alleluia. Earth and heaven chorus say, alleluia. Raise your joys and triumphs high, alleluia. Sing ye heaven and earth reply, alleluia. Love's redeeming work is done, alleluia. Fought the fight, the battle won, alleluia. Death in vain forbids him rise, alleluia. Christ has opened paradise, alleluia. Lives again our glorious King, alleluia. Where, O death, is now thy sting? Alleluia. Once he died our souls to save. Alleluia. Where's thy victory boasting brave? Alleluia. So we now where Christ has led, alleluia. Following our exalted head, alleluia. Made like him we rise, alleluia.
across the grave, the skies. Alleluia.
Amen. A wonderful gospel message this morning comes from the Gospel of John. And it comes in the 20th chapter, beginning at verse 1. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb. They saw the stone had been moved from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrapping lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and he believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside of the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb. And she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying. One at the head, the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord. I do not know where they have taken him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. And Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." But Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned, and she said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to the Father and to your Father, to my God and to your God." And Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. Word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Will you join with me in a moment of prayer? May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Now, I have to make a bit of a confession this morning, and that confession is I am not a morning person. You know, normally around this time would be when I would be waking up. And that's if I had to. You know, if I had the choice without work or family obligations, I probably would be able to sleep in even longer. Morning is not really my thing, which makes a sunrise service so interesting. You wake up for a sunrise service and hop in the shower and it's still dark outside. You get changed and you get something to eat and you grab 1 to 2 to 4 cups of coffee and it's still dark outside. You go in the car and the automatic lights turn on because it's still dark outside. This morning, myself and the AV team, the worship group was out here setting up while it was still dark. And we gathered just as the light was beginning to come. We gathered while it was still dark. You've probably heard the phrase, nothing good happens after midnight. Now, I have to admit that in my college days, I made quite a few mistakes, bad decisions in that early morning time. You know, regrets, bad decisions, even dangers, they happen in that time between midnight and dawn. Which is why we shouldn't take for granted the very fact, not only that we gathered here this morning for a sunrise service while it was still dark, but that the Easter story itself begins this way. The Easter story begins that it's the first day of the week and while it was still dark. That's what the Gospel of John tells us. While it was still dark. And it's a reminder to us that Easter does not begin with the spring and the beautiful flowers and the Easter eggs and all of these wonderful things that come to our mind when we first think of Easter. But that Easter actually still begins in the dark. Easter begins with a follower and a friend of Jesus, a mourner now, coming to the tomb to pay her respects. Easter begins with Mary Magdalene coming to the tomb to finish the burial rites that the disciples and the women didn't get to do because they had to rush pulling Jesus off of the cross on Friday and had to wait on Holy Saturday because it is the Sabbath and didn't get to do this even important act of giving him his last respects, his last rites. Mary comes while it is still dark to the tomb to mourn, to grieve. And even while it is still dark, we have the disciples huddled together in a home in fear and grief and anger at one of their own. Easter begins in the sense of hopelessness. It begins while it is dark. Again, we should not take this for granted, that Easter begins in darkness. Because as we recognize that Easter begins in darkness, what it teaches us is that when we come here this morning, our salvation does not begin when we say our shouts of Alleluia. Our salvation doesn't begin when we ourselves recognize that the tomb is empty. Our salvation doesn't begin when we, like Mary, recognize the gardener to finally be Jesus and we understand it all ourselves. What we recognize that as Easter begins while it is still dark, that God has already been at work. God was at work on the cross. God was at work in the tomb. God was at work while it was still dark. This is why St. Paul is so excited when he writes about it in Romans. He says, God demonstrates his love for us in this, that while we were sinners, Christ gave himself up for us. He says later that while we were enemies of God, we were reconciled to God. So how much more shall we gain in Jesus' life? See, all of these whiles that we read in the scripture, while we were enemies of God, while we were yet sinners, while it was still dark, talks about a God who is at work even before we recognize it, even before we know we need God, a God who is at work in the darkness, and Easter is the culmination, the celebration of the victory of God over that darkness. Easter is a reminder that God is with us in the darkest times and that God wins. God perseveres. This past year, even more than the past year, has been one of the darkest years for our nation, for our country. We have faced a pandemic that has taken a toll on us not just physically, but mentally, economically. We have experienced darkness. And yet the good news of Easter reminds us that God is at work even in the darkness. And so what we face now does not win. This is not the way it is going to be that God claims victory. As we have lost loved ones over the past year, some from the pandemic, some from other illnesses, some from senseless violence, some in just tragic ways, what Easter reminds us is even in the darkness of our grief, there is victory over death because the tomb is empty. That God is at work in our pain, in our darkness, and that the ones that we love, they are not gone from us forever, but they are forever with Christ. What we are taught as we celebrate this fact that God is at work in the darkness is that whatever we face, whatever darkness we are walking through, whether it is the pain of separation, of a divorce, it is, whether it's the fear of our own medical diagnosis, whether it is fears for our children and what they are facing, whatever we are walking through today, we recognize that God is already at work in that and that we will claim victory. God is at work. God's at work in the darkness. And because God is at work in the darkness, just as we gather this morning to go from darkness to light, we see the risen sun shine light into our world. We see the cold turn to spring, the blooming of the flowers and the beauty. We see it all and recognize the beauty of a God who turns all things, even the miserable things in our lives, into something beautiful. Who can take those things and transform them into his own victory. And thanks be to God for that. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen. One of the things that we do here at Round Hill UMC is celebrate communion, celebrate God's presence with us in our time together. And so this is an open table, which means all are invited to come. All who want to receive the elements can do so. And so I will lead us through the wonderful celebration of Christ's presence with us. And then if you would like to join us for that, you can do so. We have two different types of elements. We have a few gluten-free elements, and then we have some other elements that are just traditional grape juice and wafers. For those at home, we do something called extending the table. So as you are watching, if this is something you want to be part of, just you can email myself, pastor@roundhillumc.org, and we can set up ways for us to be able to bring you this wonderful communion elements, the body and blood of Christ as well. And so as we do this, let us join in this celebration together. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and who seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray, and free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to hear the good news that we heard this morning from St. Paul. That Christ died for us while we were yet sinners, and that proves God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. glory to God. Amen. At this time, during our normal times, we would get up and give people handshakes and hugs and pass the peace with one another. But during this time, I invite you to, you can stand and pass the peace with the traditional peace sign, if you would like. It's a way of us extending how we have experienced God's love, and now you are sharing that love with one another and showing God's peace to one another. So I invite you just to take a few moments to pass peace with one another, and peace to you who are at home as well. Now let us join together what we call a great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image, and you breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity. You made covenant to be our sovereign God. You brought us to a land flowing with milk and honey, and you set before us the way of life. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. You deliver us from slavery to sin and death, and you made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. By your great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of your Son from the dead, and to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading. Once we were no people, but now we are your people, declaring your wonderful deeds in Christ, who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. And on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. He gave thanks to you. He broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." On the day you raised him from the dead, he was recognized by his disciples in the breaking of the bread. And in the power of your Holy Spirit, your church has continued in the breaking of the bread and the sharing of the cup. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim that mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Now with the confidence of children, let us pray as Jesus taught us to pray, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The table of our Lord is prepared. As I said earlier, we have two different types of elements that you can receive, gluten-free and then just the traditional wafer and juice. They come in these prepackaged elements. If you want the gluten-free ones, it's the hourglass-shaped ones. You flip one side over and then the other. The other traditional is two different peels, so one thin layer to get the wafer and then another to get the juice. Again, this is open to all who would like to receive, so everyone is welcome to come and partake in this table of grace. Again, for those at home, let me know and I can extend this to you as well. As we are receiving, the camera will be able to show a hymn that will be sung as well, so you do not have to worry about being on camera as well. So at this time, let us join for those at home singing our hymn, and for those who would like to, you may come and receive. Once you start to hear the song, let us come and receive the grace of God. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself up for us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves up for others. As we pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As we leave, I invite you, both those who are at home and those present, we do have a 10 a.m. service that you are invited to celebrate with us in. And so we invite you. That'll be here in the same way, in person and live streamed at the same time. And we do invite you as well, if you would like to support the ministries of this church, we have in person a donation that is offering that is available. And if you're at home, there are ways in which you can either send in your offerings, you can send them in the mail, or there is a roundhillumc.org. You can go online and donate there. But with that being said, I want to just say once again, happy Easter, and to go forth into the world knowing that in your midst of darkness, in those times of grief and pain and hardship, know that God is at work, and the celebration of Easter is a reminder that there is victory. God is at work and will claim victory over the darkness. So go forth in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.